This Spig and Tough Armor is my favorite protective case for the S21 FE. And today, I'll show you seven more and tell you what I love and don't love so much about each one. Let's kick things off with one of the most protective cases on this lineup, UAG's plasma case. Straight away, you can see this follows UAG's usual design pattern of a tough, rugged looking case. The clear back is made from very hard plastic, making the case fairly stiff to get on and off the phone. However, it's not a bad thing, as at least when you drop your phone, you'll know it will stay in the case. Moving to the corners of the case, you can see it has been reinforced with tough rubber material, which also makes its way around the camera and flash. This rubber should help absorb impacts and protect the phone. You can also see that the corners are slightly raised from the rest of the case. This means there's more material to absorb impacts and also helps guarantee that the corners will make impact first. Around the screen, you can also see the rubber is used here and also gives a very nice lip to the phone. This means you'll have no worries putting the phone face down on a flat surface as the screen is lifted up. It will also help the screen gain protection as the lip should make sure the screen doesn't hit the floor when dropped. Moving to the side of the case, there are raised bumps in the plastic. This helps to add a little bit of grip to the phone and in turn makes it easier to hold. Also, you'll probably be less likely to drop the phone in the first place as it's more grippy. As with all UAG cases that I've used, the buttons are nice and flexible thanks to the rubber being slightly different in this area. There's also little slits that they add on half of the button. It means that the buttons feel great and remain clicky. So far, so good. However, a couple of things to keep in mind. First of all, as it is a protective case, it's fairly large, so you will definitely notice the extra bulk on the phone. And a little bugbear of mine is that with the case on, the phone does not lay completely flat on a table. This means the phone rocks ever so slightly when typing, if the phone is on a flat table. It's not a massive problem, however, it is a bugbear of mine. Moving on to my personal favorite normal case, this Caseology Parallax. On the back, they have this lovely 3D design, which not only feels amazing in the hands, but also adds a little bit of grip. Add to the fact that the buttons are incredibly tactile and responsive, make this a must-have case in my opinion. Although being made from rubber, it's actually fairly hard. This makes the phone feel solid and not squishy like some other protective cases do. I really appreciate the minimal branding on the back of this case with just this small little Caseology logo. The reason this is not my favorite protective case is that although it does get the fundamental protection right, I just don't think it is as protective as some of the other cases we have today. Talking about the fundamental protection, there's a decent lip around the screen, so if you put it face down on a table, you should not have to worry about the screen getting scratched. Overall, this is a fantastic case, although it's certainly not the most protective we have today. Moving on to the Rinky Onyx, this case is made from a rubber gel material, which makes getting it on and off the phone very easy as it's flexible. I would say this is probably the least protective case we have here today, but I wanted to show it off as it is a fantastic case. On the back of the case, there's a nice grippy texture, which means you don't get fingerprints on it. It also does add some grip to the phone. Around the camera bump, there's a little lip, raise it off any surfaces and give the cameras that little bit more protection. Normally, this would mean the phone would rock around. However, Rinky have been clever and have added three bumps in each of the other corners. This will stop it rocking around. Very good move from Rinky though. Moving to the side of the case, we see more grippy texture. This certainly helps you hold onto the phone and will stop you from dropping it so easily. We also find nice tactile buttons in the material, thanks to slits either side. Around the front of the case, you will find a raised lip at the top and bottom. This is so the sides of the case are not in the way for any gestures when you're swiping left and right. It also means that the screen is raised off surfaces thanks to the top and bottom bezels. Overall, a great case that will protect your phone in general everyday use. However, if you're someone that drops your phone often, you'll probably want to skip this one as it's just a rubber case. Moving on to something a lot more protective is this Elixir Armadillo case. Straight away, you can see that the cameras on the back are fully protected. You can then simply slide this out the way when you need to use them. This adds a layer of protection and privacy to your phone. Although the case does look like it will be a pig to get on and off, it's actually fairly flexible, so you should have no issues. Sliding the camera protector out the way, you can see that the case has individual cutouts for the three cameras and the flash. Back of the case might look a little bit mad, but it's not actually uncomfortable to hold. This is partly due to there being no sharp edges on the case. Also, on the back of the case is a flip-out stand. This will hold the phone up fairly well in both landscape and portrait. The stand also rotates, and as it is a ring, you can easily slide your finger through it. This will ensure that you don't drop your phone. I think this feature is really handy if you're at a festival and your arm is getting knocked about, as even if you let go of your phone, it won't actually fly out your hand. Moving to the sides, the buttons work well, but they have a very muted click, so sometimes you have to make sure you've actually pressed the button in. Another negative is that the sides of the phone are pretty smooth. This means that it is a little slippy to hold, however, it's not a big deal as you have the ring on the back to ensure you don't drop it. Next up, we have the Hybrid Armor case. First of all, I dig the design of this one. It has these fake carbon fiber inserts, which I think look pretty good. But I do admit it's probably not a look for everyone. The case is fairly thick and feels like it would protect your phone a good amount. In each corner, you can see that it's raised slightly from the rest of the case, just like we saw on the UAG. This will provide extra protection to the phone, as it should absorb impact more and also ensure that the corners hit the ground before the phone. Although easy to get the case on, it's certainly not easy to get the phone off. It's a very snug fit. There's a nice large lip around all of the screen to ensure that it doesn't hit surfaces first. And then around the sides, the buttons are flexible, which means you can press them very easily. However, just like the Elixir case from before, the click is muted, which means you do have to double check sometimes if you've pressed the button. Next up, we have Samsung's official stand case. As this is a clear case, you'll be able to see whichever of the S21 FE you've bought. You can also see on the back, there's just a big cutout for the cameras, rather than the individual ones we see on some other official S21 FE cases. Moving to the sides of the case, you can see it's ridged on both sides. This provides a good amount of grip in the hands and should actually stop you from dropping the phone easily. And as the sides are thick, some good drop protection too. The buttons are raised slightly from the rest of the case. Although the buttons do work fine, again, they are a little bit muted and don't have the same clicky feel that the UAG or Rinky had. The main reason you would pick this case up is because of the stand on the back. The stand is made from metal and has a very sturdy hinge, which allows a variety of viewing angles. Your phone can also be used in both landscape or portrait modes, perfect for the TikTokers out there. The only thing about this stand is that it actually sticks out from the rest of the case on the back, even when it's closed. This creates a bump at the bottom of the phone and it will rock around on a flat table. Slightly annoying, but if you're going to use the stand a lot, I'd say it's probably worth the trade-off. Overall, a nice case which has a lot of protection thanks to the hard plastic back and the thick sides all around the phone. Next up, we have the Zizo Bolt, which is a bit of a do-it-all case. It comes with a case with a built-in kickstand, a screen protector, a belt holder, and finally, a little lanyard. Yeah, it definitely comes with a lot. The case is also pretty large, so it's definitely not for your average user. In my mind, this is perfect for someone that does not baby the phone. You know, the type that just chucks it on the floor at the gym or on a table at the pub. The kickstand on the back of the case is a nice feature and stands the phone up well. Although on our case, it was actually quite hard to get out in the first place and ended up using a key. The belt clip can also be used as a stand and is very sturdy too. I can see this section of the case being useful for builders which might have pockets full of screws or drill bits. You can easily clip this onto your belt, at which point the screen is covered and fully protected. Then simply unclip your phone when you want to use it. The addition of a lanyard is also a nice touch if you want to keep your phone around your neck at a festival or while you're on holiday. Moving on to my top protective case for the S21 FE, this Spigen Tough Armor. As with all Spigen cases, the buttons feel fantastic. I also really appreciate the plus and minus symbols on the volume rocker and the extra grip on the power button. With the triple layered design, this case can certainly protect your phone from some serious drops, as many people have found out, as it is a very popular case. The hard outer layer makes the phone feel solid in the hands, but is not particularly grippy. It does make up for this by having a built-in kickstand though. If you are commuting on the train daily, then this kickstand will allow you to catch up on YouTube subscriptions easily and comfortably. Plus, once it's closed, it sits flush with the rest of the case. The case also has minimal branding with just the Spigen logo on the kickstand. I do wish it came in more colours though. The main reason we picked this as our top protective case is that it provides great protection while not being massive or going overboard. I'd have to say that my top three is of course the Spigen, then probably UAG's plasma case as it has great protection and is probably the best here at taking a big knock. Then finally, I would say probably Elixar's Armadillo, as it provides great protection with a built-in stand and finger loop, while also having the cameras covered. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe for S22 content coming soon. And to buy any of the cases we've talked about today, visit the links in the description below.